Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this video, we'll see about MVVM pattern. MVVM means Model View View Model. It's a software architectural pattern like MVC and MVP. All these patterns have some guidelines using which we can organize the code. Following these guidelines makes our code easy to understand. Now, we will get one question. Why do we need to go for MVVM over MVC or MVP? Before that, we need to know about some terms. Activity recreation. Android system uses different layout file according to the device width and height. When the activity window get resized, then Android look for appropriate layout. If the layout changes, then the activity will get recreated for us. For example, while rotating the screen, the activity should use a layout file from layout land. Live data. Live data is a final class which uses observer pattern to provide observer for a variable. Once the variable changes its value, then the observer get called automatically. Unlike other observer libraries, live data has lifecycle awareness, which means if your activity is not visible, then the observer won't get called. When the activity becomes visible, then it will send the latest data to the observer. Mutable live data. Mutable live data is a subclass of live data which allows to modify the value. When we want to update the value of mutable live data from main thread, then we need to use setValue method. If we want to update it from background thread, then we need to use postValue method. Nowadays, we are getting devices with dual displays and foldable display. In these kind of devices, the activity will get recreated frequently due to configuration changes. By using view model, we can overcome the problem of configuration changes. Also, it will block updating the UI when the view is not visible to the user. For example, if we create a timer application, we will update the UI for every second. When the app is minimized, we don't need to update the UI because the changes can't be seen by the user. To handle that on other patterns, we need to introduce some booleans. But in MVVM pattern, the view model triggers the observer only when the activity or fragment is visible to the user. In MVVM, view contains the code which accesses the UI component. For example, activity or fragment. Model contains the business logic like calculation and network communication. Finally, the view model is a bridge between view and model. Now, we'll see how the communication happens between these layers. The activity will access the view model. In view model, we will create a live data object. This live data is getting observed from our view. If any changes happening on the live data, then it will trigger the observer. But the live data is a final class, so we can't change the value of the object directly. To do that, we need to create a mutable live data on the repository. Then we need to set the mutable live data as a value for the live data so that both will point to the same memory location, but only the mutable object from repository allows for modification. We do this to create an abstraction between view and model so that we can avoid accidental value changes on the data. The model, also known as repository, takes care of business logic and update the appropriate mutable live data. The change on the mutable live data affects the live data. Once the live data changes its value, it will trigger the observer on the view. Like this, these three components communicate between each other, at the same time provide some abstraction. In upcoming videos, we'll see how to develop this weather application using MVVM pattern with retrofit. Once we open the application, we have a splash screen. After that, we are going to a search page, where we can search for a city and the results will be listed in a recycler view. On click of the recycler view item, we are showing the current temperature for the selected city. That's all for this tutorial guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.